What's up guys, this is Ronnie. Welcome back to our channel Total Technology Zone, and today's topic will be how to talk with CSV files using Langchain agents and OpenAI. So let me explain the tutorial within a few minutes. So basically, suppose you have one CSV file or your personal CSV file, or maybe a CSV file which is local to you, not available or not a CSV file on online. Okay, why I'm saying this thing online or offline, I'll explain this thing in maybe in the later tutorials, but try to understand the concept of this tutorial first. Suppose you have one CSV file which you already stored or save on your computer. Now you want to actually get some facts out of the CSV file, or maybe you want to actually know some information from the CSV file, or basically you want to do some data analytics tasks, but you don't want to write the Python code by your own, so that you will just ask some question and it will give you some answer, and based on that you can create your report just like a boom. Okay, so that is the fundamental objective of this tutorial. So now why Langchain agents and why LLM, why OpenAI LLM? Because OpenAI LLM means under the hood, it's kind of a ChatGPT backend, right? So basically, with the help of ChatGPT, you cannot actually use a CSV file to talk with the CSV file. Yeah, definitely there are multiple plugins are available. You can do it. You have to browse it, then you have to upload the file, and after that you can do it. But that's a different part. Here we are going to use the pure vanilla Python code to talk with our own CSV files with the help of Langchain agents and OpenAI LLM. There is a new term you guys are hearing now, so that is agent. So basically it's a Langchain component. It's a component of Langchain, or basically it's a class which will help you to take some action based on some sequence, right? And what will be the sequence? It will be decided by the LLM, or maybe the input from the maybe the output from the previous sequence, or maybe the input. Okay, so suppose you have a CSV file and you have Langchain agent and you have OpenAI LLM. So Langchain agent will use the OpenAI LLM to do the sequencing, or to develop the sequence based on the reasoning, right? So suppose you ask some question. Now Langchain adapter will read that question, and then it will use the OpenAI LLM, and after that it will do some analysis based on the CSV file, and then it will generate some sequence. Sequence 1, sequence 2, sequence 3, sequence 4, whatever. And every sequence, it is going to take some action. The sequence and the actions are going to be the responsibility of the Langchain agent. So Langchain agent is actually going to take some actions based on the sequence, based on the input you provided, and the LLM. LLM is basically used to do the reasoning. Means it will help you to generate the right sequence and generate the right action and generate the right answer. Okay, so enough of theory. So here a little bit from the Langchain documentation. So the core idea of agent is to use LLM to choose the sequence of action to take. So basically what I said. So basically a Langchain agent is actually going to use LLM to take some action, okay, based on some sequence. Okay, in chain, sequences are hard coded in agent. Language model is used to reasoning the users and agent engine to determine which actions to take and which order. So basically LLM is actually going to use to develop the sequence and develop the action or perform the action. Okay, right. So enough of talking. Now I'll be going to do the coding. So talk with CSV file using CSV agent and OpenAI. So there are multiple agents are available in Langchain adapter, CSV agent, maybe normal file agent, Excel file agent. So we'll be going to see all of them in upcoming or future videos. But right now I'm just focusing on CSV file in this tutorial, because I got so many requests, I thought of creating this tutorial. But I just want to highlight one thing. Maybe in next 4, 5 or 6 videos, I'll be going to talk truly on the Langchain agents only. So, or maybe I can reframe this in a different way. Maybe I'll be going to use different components or different agent, actually, and different agent use case to do something with the Langchain. So maybe I'll use some agent to do something on the S3 bucket file, or maybe something from the Google, or maybe whatever, what else, I'll see. But everything will be hands-on and practical. Okay, so let's open my VS Code, and this is my CSV file. So basically, maybe let me see how many rows are there. So it has total 11,000 rows are there, and basically it's a book data. And if I go here, if you see here, so it's a book ID, title, author, average rating, ISBN, ISBN 13, language, code, okay, then number of pages, so many things are there, right? So ratings is there, okay? So basically, if I just go here, so what is there? Just hold on, yeah. So basically, publication date, publisher, reviews count, reviews rating, everything is there. So I'll be going to use this CSV file to do the question answering, okay? So let's start writing our code. So first thing, we need to actually import the LLM. So it will be from langchain.llms import. So OpenAI, right? So maybe let's see. Okay, it's working. So I don't need to install anything. Sometime I keep on changing my laptop, so it happens. I don't know what happened here. Open. Okay, I don't know. Yes. Okay, now let's go to the next line. So it should be from langchain.agents.agentTypes import agent type, and last thing will be from langchain.agents import create CSV agent. Okay, so and just to show you my data frame from the, so basically this create CSV agent is going to create a pandas data frame, and based on that pandas data frame it will do some sort of reasoning based on the question. Okay, so I want to just guys that how this file looks in a data frame, vanilla data frame format. Okay, but it is not mandatory, right? So just to show you guys, I just import pandas as pd. Sorry. So basically this is going to be pd dot read csv, and we'll be going to just write books.csv, right? And we'll be just going to write print, and it will be df.head. Okay, so hopefully, so see, it looks like this: book ID, title, publication date, publisher, and so many things are there, right? So now I'll just going to create an agent. So agent is going to be create CSV agent. So first it will take LLM, the first keyword argument, and agent will be OpenAI, and maybe temperature is 0, and then path will be the CSV file path. So we'll go here, I'll just right click, copy path, and I just paste it. Okay, and then I'll be just going to select my agent type. So maybe agent underscore type equals to agent type dot, so I will 0 sort React description. Okay, and then I'll just print the agent. Let's see what is coming, what it is coming from here, what is actually giving me. So basically, yes, so basically this path is kind of this thing. So basically maybe I can just use this thing, so raw string. Okay, so see, my agent type is actually, agent is actually going to give me something here, see, something here. So this LLM agent prompt input, so many things are there, right? So it started from here, right?
Okay, so I did a spelling mistake, so because of that it is actually giving me this error. So just copy this thing. Please confirm the temperature is what you intended. Warning, temperature is not a default parameter. Temperature is what you intended. Please confirm. Okay, so basically temperature. Okay, so hopefully this will work now. Yes, so it is working. Okay, sometimes small spelling mistakes are going to give you some error. Now what is actually going to happen? I'll be going to ask some question to it, right? So basically I will write something. So maybe print agent.run and I'll ask some question. Okay, so so let me check what are the things. So title authors, how many authors are mentioned in the file. Okay, so it is going to give me how many distinct. Okay, so let's see. Some warnings are coming, just ignore. So total 6639 distinct authors are mentioned in the file. Now you can ask me, you are talking about some sequence, right? So I want to see the sequence. So for that, what is actually going to happen, you have to mention something called verbose equals to true. So maybe I can just write it here. Okay, so now what will happen, it will generate the sequence as well. Okay, so let's see, you will get the sequence now. Yes, so let me make it a little bit. See, I need to find out how many unique authors are in the data frame. So df.authors, so this is actually writing this thing. Okay, so now let me actually do something else. How many distinct authors are mentioned in the file? Okay. Maybe I can just write which author. Find the author who has most number of books. Find the author who has the most number of books. Let's see. Okay, Stephen King has the most books in this, right? So, and all these things are actually mentioned here. If you want to see the thing, see df books value.counts, it is going to give you, right. Now or maybe now I will write it is in a different way. Question, find the author who has most number of books written in non-English language. A little bit tricky. Okay, clear. And let's do. See, I know the final answer. Final answer is actually this, but how actually It is, I need to find the author who has most books written in all English language, right? So DF language code is this, authors and value counts, head one, right? And I got this thing. Now what we'll do, find the author who has the most number of book written in English language. Okay. Okay, see, if it is a mixture, then different answer. If it is an English, different answer. I mean, it is a non-English and a different answer. Okay, so now find the author who has most number of books written in year, who has most number of books published in year 2015. Let's see whether I'm getting something or not. It's a very tricky question now. Okay. See. Okay. I need to filter the data frame only includes a book published in this thing. So first it is filtering this thing and it got a data frame, right? Then it is actually doing something else. Okay. See. Now I need to find the author whose MOOC is public in this thing. Then actually it is again doing this thing, right? So it got the answer. So basically this is really interesting thing actually, right? So, and why I am selecting this agent type, because it is actually using some reasoning for taking action, and that is why I'm just taking this thing. Okay, and if you want to actually know more about this thing, just go to the Langchain documentation and search for Langchain agent types in the Google, or maybe if you just write Langchain different agent types, then it will give you the complete answer, right? So I believe you guys enjoying this tutorial now, and you thoroughly enjoyed the concept, how to actually use the CSV file for talking or chatting, or rather than getting some insight out of it. Or maybe suppose you want to develop a utility. I'm just giving you a very 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 heavyweight example. Suppose you are working for a data analytics or data engineering firm, right? So there your company executive category means, suppose your board of director or managing director or maybe very senior level, like a person who belongs to a very senior level, right? So he wants to actually get some insight from the data. You are definitely not going to teach him the coding, right? And at the same point of time, you are not going to do the coding for him or her on an on-demand basis. Suppose today they are going to give you a file X, tomorrow they are going to give you a file Y. So every time you have to do coding, right? Now, if you want to actually develop this utility, I already developed this utility in 5 lines of code, right? Now, your job is actually, you have to create an API, right, from this thing. And you have to create a backend and you have to create a frontend. So then what will happen? This path will be going to come from the frontend. And it will hit this backend, right? And the executive will actually going to get the answer. Means there will be a front end where executive is actually going to upload the file, and the backend is written with this same code, and it will generate the answer. So the executive or whoever is your client is going to get the answer without knowing the code or without knowing the context behind the development, right? So this is the kind of utility right now every company is actually looking for. And people are thinking that it's a very huge or very complex thing to develop. But now I give you a gist out of it. So now you guys can develop your concept intuition through it and try to develop some use case. And what are the things just now I explained? My plan is to actually create an API first with the help of that. And after that, we'll try to create a full-fledged application. So creating an API, I'll try to do it in the next tutorial, but creating a full-fledged application will require some sort of backend knowledge and some sort of front-end knowledge. Backend knowledge, we can use it using this thing,
with a Python fast API, and for front end we can use any JavaScript framework. So that will be done maybe in the future when I will start the project work. But I'm just going to give you an example that how these things can be integrated with some real world industry like specific use case. Okay, so that's it guys. Now I'll be going to conclude the tutorial, but before I conclude the tutorial I would like to request you guys on three things, right? First thing, please try to subscribe to our channel, hit the like button and also hit the bell notification so you should not miss any notification regarding our future videos, right? Second thing guys, please try to put some honest feedback on the comment box, good or bad, doesn't matter, it has to be honest. If you think something is missing in the video or something can be done in a better way or something you don't like in the video, please try to inform us so that we can actually improve our quality and come back with a better quality in the next time. And if you think something is helpful or something is helping on this video, just try to inform us with that appreciation, because this sort of appreciations are going to motivate us. And also if you put some comment, it will actually help us to align with the Google algorithm, and Google algorithm will help us to actually reach the larger audience, and that will ultimately boost our motivation as well. And last but not least, try to share our videos with your family and friend, whoever you think will get some benefit out of it. Okay, that is also indirectly help us to reach the larger audience base, right? And most important thing, it's a recommendation. Don't just try to watch our videos. Watch our videos 2 times, 3 times, and after that, whatever just now I did, try to do the same thing by your own. Means try to write the coding by your own and try to do something different. Okay, so that will help you to actually gain some confidence, and you will push yourself to the next level. And ultimately, the more code you write or more coding you will do, it will help you to reach the expertise level sooner. Okay, so that's it guys, we'll see you in the next video. Till then, take care, goodbye, and have a nice day.